parametric analysis is one of the quantitative analytical method, and it is most important in the analytical chemistry. In this video, we are going to see the gravimetric analysis part first. Under this, the common ion effect and solubility product and its principle, conditions for good precipitation, factors affecting precipitation like acid, temperature, nature of solvent, supersaturation, and precipitation formation. The first term is most important, that is the solubility. Solubility is maximum quantity of a solute get dissolved in minimum amount of solvent at a particular temperature. Now for solubility, we require the solute and solvent. Solute and solvent may be solid, liquid, or gases. Suppose one of the compound or one of the solute get dissolved in the particular solvent, that means we are observing that the solute get dissolved into the solvent. Now this dissolution may be by the association, may be by dissociation, may be ionization, or may be complex formation. Any one of the methods takes place for the dissolution of the solute. Now when the solvent and solute, maybe a solid, liquid, gas, when they combine together to give the formation of solution. Now in the solution, we observe that the how much quantity of the solute get dissolved into the how much quantity of the solvent. Now this is related to the solubility. Now solubility is the maximum quantity of solute get dissolved in minimum amount of solvent at particular temperature. Now it is the property of a solid, liquid, or gases, chemical substances called solute to dissolve in a solid, liquid, or gases solvent. The solubility of a substance fundamentally depends on the physical and chemical properties of the solute and solvent, as well as on the temperature, pressure, and presence of other chemicals. Now, these are the factors which relate to the how much quantity of the solute get dissolved into the particular amount of solvent. Now another term, that is the solubility product. Now it is the product of molar concentration of ions is a constant at a solubility and at a particular temperature. It is the equilibrium constant for solid substances dissolving in an aqueous solution. Now for example, in case of the AB is a solid. Now it dissociates into the A plus, plus B minus, and when we observe that the equilibrium constant K is equal to the concentration of A plus into concentration of the B minus divided by concentration of the AB, that is the undissolved part of the AB into the solvent. Now this solvent product is a constant, or concentration is a constant. It is denoted by K dash. That is undissolved part. Now K into K dash is equal to the product of ions of A plus and B minus. Now this product is called as a solubility product of the compound. Now that salt, when dissolved into the particular solvent, now it has a capacity to dissolve into the particular quantity of the solvent. Now this is called as a solubility product. Now solubility and solubility product, these two terms are most important in case of the precipitation formation. Now solubility product for the some salts are given here. For magnesium fluoride, it gives the solubility product Ksp equal to the concentration of magnesium ion into the concentration of fluorine ion raised to square or raised to 2. In case of the silver chromate, now Ksp is the square of the concentration of silver ion into the concentration of chromate ion. In case of silver chloride, the Ksp is a concentration of silver ion into concentration of chlorine ion. In case of barium sulfate, the Ksp is a barium ions, concentration of barium ion into concentration of the sulfate ion dissolved into the water. Now in case of the silver chromate also, now we observed that these type of Ksp's are given here. Now these Ksp's, from these Ksp, these are the solubility product when they dissolve in a particular amount of solvent at a particular temperature. Now when the third term, like ionic product, The solubility product and ionic product, by definition, these are the product of the concentration of ions present in the solution. But what happened? The ionic product is varied with the solubility product. The solubility product is the fixed quantity because it is a particular, at a particular temperature, maximum quantity get dissolved into the minimum amount of solvent. It may be in per liter, per ml, per 100 ml like that. But this value is at a particular temperature, it is a constant. But ionic product, the product of the ions present in the solution, it may vary. How much quantity of compound added into the solvent, on this basis, the ionic product is dependent. Now we know that the three conditions are there, and these three conditions are most important for the precipitation. Now, first condition is the ionic product is less than the solubility product, where when the small quantity of the substance or salt get transferred into the solvent, particular amount of solvent, then it get dissolved. When ionic product is less than solubility product, then we are saying that is a solution is unsaturated, and therefore we does not observe the any precipitate. Now, in case of the when ionic product compound is going continuously going to add, at the particular condition, the ionic product and solubility product are same. At that time, what happens? The precipitation starts to occur, but after stirring, it again disappear. Where? Because the solubility product and ionic product, they are same, equal, and therefore solution becomes a saturated, but there is no precipitation. But slowly it forms the precipitate. When we stir, it disappear or it dissolves. The third condition is there, the ionic product is exceeds than the solubility product. When the maximum quantity of the substance get added into the solvent, then it remains as it is because the ionic product is maximum or exceeds than the solubility product. At this condition, the precipitation is present into the solution. Now, this condition is called as a supersaturated condition, where precipitation occur because ionic product is exceeds than the solubility product. Now, when we tested here, the small quantity is added, and when we stir, immediately it get dissolved. After a certain time, when we are going to add the substance continuously, we are stirring here, this again dissolve because it is a unsaturated condition. At saturated condition, what happened? When we add the solute, it starts to form the precipitate. After stirring, immediately it get dissolved. But the solution get is a saturated solution. And when the next molecule or the next molecule is added, next molecule of the salt is added, it gives the formation of the precipitate. After stirring, it gives the formation of precipitate. In this way, the ionic product and solubility product, we observed that the ionic product is very varied quantity, but solubility product is a fixed quantity at a particular temperature. Now the third term, that is a common ion effect. Now this is also affect on the solubility as well as the solubility product. The common ion effect describes the effect on the decrease in the solubility of the solute and on equilibrium that occurs when one of the common ion is added to the solution. Now, degree of dissociation, that means small quantity of the substance get dissolved. For example, acetic acid dissociate into the water. Dissociate means partially it is soluble, partially ionized. Now, when the degree of dissociation of an electrolyte is suppressed by addition of another electrolyte containing the common ion. For example, in this case, the hydrogen ion or acetate ion, if we add the solution, this reaction get backward and it gives the formation of acetic acid. Now this effect is called as common ion effect. Now the ionization of the weak electrolyte, for example, acetic acid, is suppressed by adding the strong electrolyte, sodium acetate containing acetate ion is common, or we can add the acid as a hydrogen ion common. Now the reason is that when equilibrium constant for such a type of dissociate reaction, Ka is equal to, for acetic acid, is a concentration of acetate ion into hydrogen ion divided by concentration of acetic acid. Now, when we add any one of the common, like either acetate ion or hydrogen ion, the numerator value is increased. Automatically, denominator value should be increased to get the constant to keep the constant as the equilibrium constant, and therefore backward reaction takes place and precipitation occur. Now in this way, the degree of dissociation alpha is related to the equilibrium constant, and when we add the common ion, the precipitation again starts. Now conditions for the good precipitation, we know that when precipitation should be a very good, and for this purpose the precipitation should be dilute in the dilute solution. Reagent should be added slowly with constant stirring. The precipitation is carried out in warm solution. The precipitate should be digested. The precipitate should be washed with the proper dilute solution. Re-precipitation should be done in solute, with the suitable solvent. Now, if we maintain these good conditions to get the good precipitation. Now, factors affecting the precipitation. Now, for precipitation, the intermolecular forces, it affects on the precipitation. Intermolecular force, that is the in salt, the ions are there. Now in ions, how much intermolecular force is depend, whether it is a strong intermolecular force or weak intermolecular force, it affect the precipitation. Acid and salt effect. Now it is the general observation that the solubility of a sparingly soluble salt of a strong acid increases upon addition of strong acid. Now this effect is similar to the salt effect, therefore it is called as acid salt effect. Now other species dissolve into the solvent, because what type of impurity or other species are present in the solution, that also affect on the precipitation. Common ion effect, when we add any common ion, then the weak electrolyte, that is the solubility, gets suppressed. Now saturation, the saturation condition may be shifted by addition of the any salt, or when we are adding the any further salt, the saturation gets shifted. And when it is a super saturation, the precipitation occur. If it is unsaturation, then precipitation does not occur. The polarity is also most important factor. When the if the precipitate has a polar in nature, then it is a highly soluble into the polar solvent. And if it is a non-polar precipitate is there, it dissolves into the non-polar solvent. If we take the for polar solute, if you take the non-polar solvent, then the precipitation maximum, and vice versa. The another factor is the temperature. The temperature is the most important factor, because the solubility product is depend on the temperature. Therefore, the solubility is also depend on the temperature and nature of solvent. Now, what type of solvent is used, whether it is a protic solvent or polar solvent or non-polar solvent, it affect on the precipitation. And these are the factors which affect the precipitation. Now, in case of the super saturation condition, now when we are thinking about the saturated condition, at that saturated condition where the precipitation starts to occur, and after certain time when we stir this solution, the precipitate get dissolved or disappear. Now this disappearance at the super saturated solution it's occur when we increase the temperature, or we affect the these factors, the temperature, pressure. Now this affects on the precipitation. Now when we add the seeding agent, or so maybe for example, in case of the salt solution, if we add the non-polar solvent, then these are acting as a seeding agent, and it affect, it helps to get the precipitation. Now according to the one Wiman particle size relation, the Q minus S upon S, where Q is the total concentration of the substance used for the precipitation and S is the solubility. Now according to this relation, the for crystalline precipitate, the this ratio should be as small as possible, and for smaller particle size the reactant concentration should be the high, and therefore it affect on the supersaturation. Now in this topic, just we discussed on the first part of the gravimetric analysis, like common ion effect, solubility, solubility product, its principle, what are the conditions of the good precipitation, factors affecting the precipitation like acid, temperature, nature of solvent like that, and in case of the supersaturation, the precipitation formation, the formula related to the particle size. In this way, we discuss on the topic in the part.